As you probably know, most of the courts around the world are made of plaster, and most of them are exactly the same size. There was a time when squash courts were made to any specification that you wanted, because at the beginning, a lot of squash courts were private, so people built them based on the, you know, the size of the area that they were building. So there were some that were quite big, some that were quite small. And I might explore that in another video, because I think that that would be pretty cool, in the same way that that football pitches, association football, soccer, depend on, you know, what you know it as, they have different sizes and there's like a limit. And I kind of think that that might be kind of cool for squash. But anyway, that's maybe another topic. So plaster is the de facto way of making courts, but there are others. Of course, there are glass courts, which are generally, or when I was involved in squash, they were not glass, they were perspex, a kind of a plastic, whereas now they might actually be made of glass. I don't really know, I don't think so, but we still call them that, like the glass court. And then there's that court in New York which is made of steel, which is like super cool. But nearly everybody plays on plaster courts. But what is different is the back wall. And when the company that invented glass walls, they kind of opened up the game. I mean, that was a huge change for people. They, instead of just standing on the balcony and just, I don't know, maybe 30 or 40 people looking over the balcony, suddenly you could have a couple of hundred. And then, of course, maybe you had balconies around the front. But this week's question is really about the glass wall or the environment itself. Do you prefer to play on plaster walls, back walls, or glass walls? Now, I know that some courts have kind of like some windows in, and nowadays a lot of places have glass doors, so there's a huge variation. And I think that I prefer glass walls, and I think I prefer that because generally they're more open in the back. I mean, I'm sure they exist, but I've never seen them. I'm sure that there's some places that just has a glass wall, a back wall, but then still has a balcony. And that wouldn't be so much fun for me. So as soon as there's a glass wall, suddenly the whole area opens up and it just seems so much more spacious. Now, I have played on some courts that had no balcony at all, and there was no viewing gallery, there was nothing. And I kind of like that as well. That's kind of like almost a complete opposite. I suppose the glass court is the complete opposite, but for most people, the idea that nobody watches you, whatever happens in there is just between you and the people on that court, if you're playing doubles or two against one or something. So, you know, back to that question, do you prefer a glass wall? A lot of people find it difficult to concentrate, especially if there's like people moving around at the back, or there's other matches and you can see people sort of heating up and stuff like that. Some people find it hard to concentrate on watching the ball because their attention is drawn to people's bags, or there's lots of different colours, whereas the plaster wall is just a consistent colour. So a simple question this week, very curious to see what people think, and maybe talk about some other of the courts that you've got, in the sense that, have you played on a court with one glass wall? I've seen those on the internet. That would be a little bit strange for me. Would be interesting from a tactical point of view, how different the side walls are as far as boasts are concerned, and, you know, well, I suppose disposed, really. So that'd be kind of interesting. So there we go. What's your preference? Plaster or glass? On the screen at the moment, somewhere up here, is a playlist of all of the other questions for you to look at. And probably down here somewhere is another video that YouTube thinks is a really good fit for you. And probably down here is a subscription button. If and only if you think my content is useful, please consider subscribing. And remember, do something every single day to improve your squash. See ya.